case 2. Electric field intensity on surface point. Surface point. What is our conductor? This is our conductor. This is our conductor. Right? What is the charge? Q is the charge. Q is the charge. Q is the charge. Now what is the radius? R is the radius. Now let us consider there is a point B. There is a point B. On the point B, we want to calculate electric field intensity. Now imagine a Gaussian point, imagine a Gaussian surface which is passing through the point B. Now here is the Gaussian surface, here is also Gaussian surface, here is also Gaussian surface, right? Now here Gaussian surface, here is also Gaussian surface. Now Gaussian surface radius is small r, conducting sphere radius is capital R. But in this case, as the point is on the surface point. Conducting sphere radius is capital R and Gaussian surface radius also capital R. Now here in this case, flux is equals to, now this is called Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. Now at this point, what is the electric field intensity? E. On the Gaussian surface, let us imagine a small area. This is the small area. Now, that small area is represented by ds. Area vector is, what to say, n cap. In this case also, the small area ds, magnitude. Area vector is n cap, which is radially outward. Electric field intensity is also radially outward. Therefore, both are in the same direction. Theta is equals to, what you say, 0. Now flux is equals to closed integral of E ds cos theta. Now flux is equals to closed integral of E ds, theta is equals to cos 0. Therefore flux is equals to closed integral of E ds cos 0 is equals to 1. Flux is equals to E, which is constant, closed integral of ds. Now ds, the total area of the Gaussian surface. Total area of the Gaussian surface. What is the radius of the Gaussian surface? Capital R is the radius of the Gaussian surface. Now this is equals to, phi is equals to, right, 4 pi into, because the Gaussian surface radius is capital R, therefore it is also radius. Therefore the flux is equals to, phi is equals to E into 4 pi R square, according to the Gauss law. According to Gauss law, that is, flux is equals to Q by epsilon naught. Now what is the flux calculation? E into, that is, 4 pi epsilon, 4 pi into R square is equals to, that is, Q by epsilon naught. Therefore E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Here is also, outside point is at a small r distance, Q by small r square. Surface point is at a distance of capital R, therefore Q by capital R square. Now E is equals to, already we know that 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q is equals to sigma into 4 pi R square. Q is equals to, that is, sigma into 4 pi into capital R square by R square. Therefore 4 pi gets cancelled, R square gets cancelled, E is equals to sigma by epsilon naught. Therefore on the surface point, the electric field intensity E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by capital R square. The electric field intensity E is equals to sigma by epsilon naught. Now the case third, inside point.
What is our conducting sphere? This is the conducting sphere. Right? That is, this is the center. Now this is called, what to say, radius. What is the charge on the sphere? This is the charge on the sphere. This is the charge on the sphere. Now let us consider there is a point C. Let us consider there is a point C. That point C is inside the sphere. Now imagine a Gaussian surface. Imagine a Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. In this Gaussian surface, there is no charge. As there is no charge, electric field intensity is also nothing. That means zero. Therefore, here in this case, this Gaussian surface, within the Gaussian surface, there is a charge. Here in this, within the Gaussian surface, there is a charge. But the point which is inside, imagine a Gaussian surface, right? Inside the Gaussian surface, there is no charge. Therefore, inside the Gaussian surface, there is no charge. As there is no charge, the flux is equals to zero. As the flux is equals to zero, electric field intensity is also zero. Therefore, now, what is our topic? Spherical charged conducting shell. We want to calculate electric field intensity at outside point, on the surface point, and inside point. The electric field intensity at outside point, which is at a distance of small r, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by small r square. On the surface point is at a distance of capital R, that is E is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. But whereas in the case of inside point, right, imagine the Gaussian surface, within the Gaussian surface there is no charge. There is no charge means the flux within the closed surface equals to zero. Flux is equals to zero, therefore electric field intensity is zero. Therefore inside the conducting sphere there is no electric field intensity.